Hello students, welcome to my class. In our previous video, we have completed 6 questions of miscellaneous exercise of chapter relations and functions of class 11. Today we will continue with the 7th question. Let F and G from R to R be defined respectively by f of x is equal to x plus 1 and g of x is equal to 2x minus 3. Find f plus g, f minus g and f by g. So here operations on real numbers, that concept only we are going to use. So the functions f of x is defined as x plus 1 and g of x is equal to 2x minus 3. Now the first one, f plus g of x. So the definition of addition of real functions, that is f plus g of x is equal to f of x plus g of x. So this is the formula, addition of two real numbers. So here f of x is given as x plus 1 and g of x is 2x minus 3. Now you add, you will get 3x minus 2. So this is the sum of the real functions, that is f plus g. So we got the answer, f plus g is equal to 3x minus 2. Now next is f minus g of x, that is the difference of two real functions. This definition is f of x minus g of x, which is equal to f of x is x plus 1 minus g of x is 2x minus 3. So x plus 1 minus 2x plus 3, when you simplify these two you will get minus x plus 4. So f minus g of x will be minus x plus 4. So the second part over. Now the third one, f divided by g. So here f division of two real function, that is f divided by g is equal to x plus 1. The formula is f divided by g of x is equal to f of x by g of x. So this is the formula. Here f of x is x plus 1. So x plus 1 by 2x minus 3. Here the condition is 2x minus 3 should not be equal to 0, or in another word we can say that x should not be equal to 3 by 2. So this further we cannot simplify, so this is the value f by g, that is x plus 1 by 2x minus 3. Now the next question, question number 8. Let f is equal to ordered pair, set ordered pair 1 1 2 3 0 minus 1 minus 1 minus 3 be a function from z to z defined by f of x is equal to ax plus b for some integers a comma b. So determine a and b. So here we are given a function f of x is equal to ax plus b is the function defined from z to z. Z is set of integers. So f is defined from z to z. And the elements of f is given as f is equal to ordered pair 1, 1, 2, 3, 0, comma, minus 1 and minus 1, comma, minus 3. So these are the elements of the function f. Our question is, we have to find the value of a and b. It's very easy question. So here if you see, all these elements will satisfy this function. We can say that this will satisfy this function. That is, we can substitute in the place of x and the function, this f of x, the second element will be the function f of x. So we will be substituting each one or two ordered pair, we will be substituting in the given function. So you will get a linear equation in a and b. Solving that, you will get the value of a and b. So first we will take the first ordered pair 1 1. So here the value of x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1. So here y is nothing but f of x. So in this function, we will, in equation 1, we will substitute these values. So y is nothing but f of x. 1 is equal to a into 1 plus b. So what we got is a plus b is equal to 1. So this is the second equation. Now we will take another. Either you can substitute, you can take this ordered pair 2, 3, or I can take this also. So next I am going to take the ordered pair 0, comma minus 1. Any two ordered pair in this function you can take. So 0, comma minus 1. Its meaning x is equal to 0 and y is equal to minus 1. So these two values I am going to substitute in equation 1. So y is nothing but f of x. So minus 1 is equal to a into 0 plus b. So here from this expression we will get the value of b. So b is equal to minus 1. So we got the value of b from here, and this value if you substitute in equation 1, so substituting value of b, substituting value of b in equation 2, you'll get the value of a. So a plus b value is minus 1. So a plus minus 1 is equal to 1. So a is equal to 1 plus 1. So a is equal to 2. So we got the value a is equal to 2 and b is equal to minus 1. So this is how you have to find the values of a and b. Now next question. Question number 9. Let R be a relation from n to n defined by R is equal to ordered pair AB such that A, comma B belongs to n and A is equal to B square. Are the following are true? That is the question. First one, ordered pair A, comma A belongs to R for all A belongs to n. Second question, A, comma B, AB, ordered pair AB belongs to R implies BA belongs to R. Third question, AB, ordered pair AB belongs to R, BC belongs to R implies AC belongs to R. So here first we will start with the relation. So the relation is given as set of all ordered pair AB. So such that A comma B belongs to N, that is A and first and the second element should be a natural number. And the condition A is equal to B square. So what is its meaning? First element should be the square of the second. So first element should be a square number. Okay, first element is the square of the second. So this is the condition, second element. So this is the condition. If the ordered pair satisfies this condition, then that element belongs to the relation R. So here they have given three statements. We have to check whether the statements are true or not. So we will start with the first statement. So the question is A comma A belongs to R. So what is its meaning? A comma A belongs to R means A should be a natural number. And the second condition, A should be equal to the square of the second. Here the second element is also A. So A is equal to A square. So what is its meaning? Can you find any natural number whose square is equal to that number? Except one. We have only one satisfying this condition. If you take A is equal to 1, then A square is also 1. So we can say that we can write 1, 1 belongs to R. If you take any other number, A is equal to 2. So A square will be 4. So the ordered pair will be 4, 2. So here the first element and the second element are not same. So this condition is not satisfied for other numbers except one. So this statement is not true. So this statement is a false statement only. So this is a false statement. False. Now the second question is AB belongs to R implies BA belongs to R. Is it true? The question is if AB is an element of R. So we will take A is equal to 4 and B is equal to 2. So the first element is the square of the second element. So we can say that 4, 2 belongs to R. Yes. Now we have to check whether this implies if 4, 2 belongs to R, then what is the meaning of this statement? Then 2, 4 also belongs to R. That meaning of this is 4, 2 2 belongs to R implies 2, 4 belongs to R. Is it correct? You just check. Because R is defined as the first element should be the square of the second element. So here this is correct. But what about for this ordered pair? Is 2 is a square of 4? No, this ordered pair, this is wrong. Actually, this ordered pair will not belongs to the relation R. So if AB belongs to R, which does not implies that BA also belongs to R. So this condition is also not true. So this is also a false statement. So this is false. Now the third one also similar only. So if AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R, if AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R implies AC belongs to R. So this is what we have to prove. If AB belongs to R, then we have to prove that BC belongs to R. So we will take B is equal to 4 and A is equal to 16. We will start with the first one. So 16, 4 belongs to R. Yes, because the first element is the square of the second element. So 16, 4 belongs to R. Now B is equal to 4, then what will be C? C is equal to 2. So the second this expression we will write 4, 2 belongs to R. Yes, correct. Here the first element is the square of the second element. So 4, 2 also belongs to R. So we have these two conditions. So 16, 4 belongs to R and 4, 2 belongs to R, which implies AC. So we will take AC. A is what we have taken. A is equal to 16 and C is equal to 2. Is this ordered pair belongs to R? You just check the condition. What should be the condition? First element is the square of the second element. Here you check whether this condition is satisfied by this ordered pair. Here 16 is not the square of the element 2, that is this does not belongs to R. That means if AB belongs to R and BC belongs to R does not implies AC belongs to R. So this statement is also false. So here in this question, for the given relation, these three statements are not true. They are false statement only. Now next question. So question number 10, let A is equal to set 1, 2, 3, 4, B is equal to set 1, 5, 9, 11, 15, 16 and F is equal to ordered pair 1, 5, 2, 9, 3, 1, 4, 5, 2, 11 are the following true. So first question is F is a relation from A to B and the second one F is a function from A to B. Justify your answer in each case. So here what is given, two sets A and B are given. So A is equal to set 1, 2, 3, 4 and B is equal to set 1, 5, 9, 11, 15, 16. And F is given as 1, 5, 2, 9, 3, 1, 4, 5, 2, 11. So the first question is, we have to check whether this statement is true or not. F is a relation from A to B. So we have to find what is the definition of a relation. Relation is the subset of the Cartesian product A and B. That means Cartesian product means first element should be from the first set and the second element should be from the second set. So what you have to verify, in each ordered pair you have to check whether the first elements are from A and the second elements are from B. So we will start checking from the first ordered pair. So 1 belongs to A and 5 is in B. 2 belongs to A and 9 is in B. 3 belongs to A and 1 belongs to B. 4 belongs to A and 5 belongs to B. And 2 belongs to A and 11 belongs to B. Yes. So here if you see this collection of ordered pair, that is F is a subset of, actually we can write F is a subset of A cross B. Therefore we can say that F is a relation from A to B. F is a relation from A to B. So this is the first one. Second condition, second one, you have to check whether F is a function from A to B. So your function definition, no two ordered pair will have the same first element. So that condition we will check in this relation F. Here if you see the ordered pair 2, 9 and 2, 11. So these two ordered pair are having same first element. So we can relation cannot be a function. This is not possible in a function. So we can say that F is not a function. F is a relation, but F is not a function, since here we have a two ordered pair have a same first element. So the given F, that is given relation F, is not a function. Now next question. Question number 11. Let F be the subset of Z cross Z defined by F is equal to ordered pair AB, A plus B such that A, B belongs to Z. Is F a function from Z to Z? So here the relation F is defined from Z to Z. It is given that F is a subset of Z cross Z. So we can say that F is a relation. So F is a relation given as AB, ordered pair AB, A plus B, where A, B belongs to Z. So this is the relation defined. And what we have to find is whether we have to check whether F is a function or not. So for that we will take values for A and B. So I am taking first, I will take A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 6. So what will be the element of this function F, we will find out. So AB, I will get as the product of these two. The first element is AB, that is 1 into 6, so you will get a 6. And the second element is A plus B, that is 1 plus 6 is equal to 7. So we can say that 6, 7 belongs to F. 6, 7 belongs to F for A equal to 1 and B equal to 6. Now I am going to take A is equal to 2, another example, A is equal to 2 and B is equal to 3 I am going to take now. Now I will first, I will find AB value, that is 2 into 3 I am getting 6, and A plus B, A plus B is 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. So we can write 6, 5 belongs to F. So here if you see, for taking different values of A and B, what we got is two elements of F we got, in that the first elements are same. So actually these two belongs to F. Actually the relation F, we got two ordered pair in relation F. If you check this ordered pair, the first element is same. So this F cannot be a function. So F is not a function. F is a relation, but F cannot be a function. Now 12th question. Question number 12. Let A is equal to set 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and F from A to N be defined by F of N is equal to the highest prime factor of N. Find the range of F. So first we will start with the relation, that is the relation F from A to N defined by, this is the condition actually, F of N is equal to the highest prime factor of N. So N is the elements of A, because here the function is defined from, or the relation is defined from A to N. So all the elements of A will be N. So first we will find out the elements of the relation F, then only we can find the range. So first we will start with the first value 9. So if you take 9, what is the F of N value? The second element will be the highest prime factor of N. So if the first element is N, then the second element should be the highest prime factor of this first element. So here first element is 9. So what is the highest prime factor of 9? 9 is 3 into 3. So highest prime factor is 3. So we can write the ordered pair 9, 3. Now we will take the second element of A, 10. First element is 10. So second element will be the highest prime factor of 10. So 10, you know that 2 into 5. So here 2 and 5 are prime number. Out of these two prime number, 5 is the highest prime number. So we will write the ordered pair as 10, 5. Now we'll start with the next number, that is 11. 11 is a prime number, so the highest prime number is also 11 only. Now the 12. So 12 we can write as 2 square into 3. 12 is 2 square into 3. So here 2 and 3 are prime factors. Out of these two, highest prime factor is 3. So the ordered pair will be 12, 3. Now the last number 13. 13 is again a prime number. So the prime factor is also 13 only. So we got the elements of the relation F. So now we have to find the range of F. So what do you mean by range of F? The collection of all the second element in the ordered pair. So all the second element in the ordered pair will give you the range. So we can write 3, 5, 11, 13. So in a set we will not repeat the element. So we got the range of F is equal to 3, 5, 11 and 13. So we have completed the miscellaneous chapter. In my next video we will discuss a new chapter. So if you like my channel, you can share and subscribe. Your subscription my motivation. Thank you students.